Okay, now we're going to learn how to read the files that we just learned how to create. So again, we'll go to File and we'll go and we'll create a new menu item, Open. I call it Open Item over here. And again, you'll go to Event and Action Event, Action Performed. Okay, now in this case, what we're going to do is we're going to call a method now Open File. Again, remember, we're trying to avoid keeping our code inside the event. Okay, so we'll come down over here. Okay, and let's see what open file looks like. If you remember, save file like this, for a lot of it actually looks about the same. Okay, and before what we had was my chooser show save dialog, and now we have show open dialog, so it knows that we're trying to save here and we're trying to open on this side. Okay, the other thing too, I think, is also on the tab of the window that opens, it also says save versus open. Okay, and again, return a value. We were able to successfully choose a name, and so we only do this if we are ready to open a real file. Again, we take the file name and we go ahead and give it and go ahead and list the file here. Again, it contains a lot more information than just the name. It also probably contains the path about where the file is located on the file system, okay, or on your computer. Okay, rather than having a writer, okay, over on this side, we're going to have a reader, okay, and it's going to actually be used to read the file, okay, this file that we chose. Now, once we have a reader, then we're going to go ahead and have a buffered reader, okay, so this is a lot of steps, actually, more to get this. So that creates a buffered reader, okay. And then what we have to do, okay, this is a little more cumbersome, is first we're going to create a string buffer and we're going to call it input, and we're going to create another string called temp. And what we're going to do is we're actually going to read the buffer, okay, this buffer right here of the reader, line by line, okay. And that's because your code or your program may actually contain more than one line of strings or of information. So in this case, we're just going to read one line at a time. And we're going to set that line to this temp. And then what this is doing is it's going to check whether it's null or not. And at that point, it's going to finish reading the file. Okay. So a little more cumbersome right there. Okay. But once it's determined that yes, there's a line there, okay, that is not null, then it'll go ahead and append our buffered reader called input right there. And so we'll add that to that. Now, once we do that, then we'll go ahead and go to the my panel one, and this is the method we're going to create inside my panel one to handle the input of the file information right there. Okay, and of course, just like before, we have to close the reader or the writer, and just like before, we had this try catch method so that we could see if there's any errors while we're doing that. Okay, so let's go ahead and go to my panel and let's take a look at set file. So set file, in analogy to get file like this, we're going to go ahead and call a method in our library of IO or inputs and outputs. And what we're going to pass it is we're going to pass it atoms and we're going to pass it electrons. Excuse me. The list of atoms and electrons, and then we're going to pass it an input. Okay? The string that we had before. And of course, after we finish setting the file, we're going to have a new picture, so we better run the Z sort. Okay, so now here's the meat and potatoes, or the more complicated part, reading the IO, okay, or the input and output. Okay, so again, it's a static method, and we're going to go ahead and pass to it the list of atoms and the electrons, and then the buffered reader, or the string that we're actually getting from the file. Okay, and the first thing we're going to do is we're going to determine how many atoms there are right now. Because what this is going to allow us to do is that if we've already drawn something and we open something, we can actually put it on top of what we already had. Okay, so this is a way of actually being able to replicate things. Okay, because you could actually create, let's say, a library of alpha amino acids, and then when you wanted, you could go ahead and import them and then connect the pieces together, so that you won't have to draw as much as you do from scratch. Okay. Now, here's the important part of the reading function. Okay, there's this kind of variable called the string tokenizer. Okay, and what the string tokenizer does, okay, it creates tokens which are basically just the pieces like this, okay? The pieces that we're going to break down the input string to. So the string tokenizer, it needs a string, so that's why we have to do input to string. And then this is the space that we kept on creating before, or adding, appending. Remember up here, we had space here, right? So in this case, now we have that space. And so what the string tokenizer is doing, it's going to actually chop off or chop up our string based on this character right here. And since we told it it's a space, then it's just going to divide things by spaces. We could also use commas or semicolons or whatever you wanted to use as the token or the thing to split your string apart. Okay, now that we have that, then how do you read the tokens? All you have to do with tokens is you go ahead and say tokens next token, and that'll give you the next string that's divided by the space. Okay. And what we want to do is that when we get this information, since it's reading a file, it doesn't know anything about numbers. All it knows is about text, okay, or strings. So what we have to do is we have to call this this method from the library of integers, and the method is called parseInt, which basically means it's going to convert this string over to an integer, and that's how we're going to keep track of how many atoms we're actually going to feed into the program. Okay, so now we're going to loop from index 0 to less than the number of atoms, like that. And of course, we're going to loop by adding one unit every time. Now, to the atoms, what we're going to do is we're going to create a new atom. Okay, so here's new atom. And what are we going to put in the new atom? Well, we're going to, again, tokens next token is going to read the next string. And so in the case of elements, we can just keep it a string. And then for charge, we're going to read the next token, but this float.parseFloat is going to convert it over to a float, because that's what we need if you look up the definition of the constructor for atom. And then for color, what we're going to do is, remember we saved the color as an integer, and then that was converted to a string. So now we're reversing the process. Here we're reading the string, here we're converting it over to an integer. And then what we need to do to convert it over to a color is that we need to put that integer number into the one of the constructors for color. And one of the constructors for color is actually not just to put RGB, but to put all this integer the way we actually stored it, okay? Then we're going to read the next token and convert that over to the X value. Read the next token, convert that over to the Y value. Read the last token of at least the atom list and convert that over to the Z value, okay? Okay, so now we've created... we've actually augmented or added the atoms based on the list that we just read from our file. Okay, the next thing we're going to do now is we're going to read the next token, which is going to be an integer, which is going to be the number of electrons. Okay, remember this was a file format that we followed here. In fact, you can be creative and create your own file format with the same information that I'm showing you. You can do whatever format you want like this. Okay, but what you must make sure is that your writing method corresponds to your reading method. Otherwise, nothing's ever going to make sense, okay? Okay, so we're going to read the number of electrons. We're going to index or go through every one of the electrons in this list. Okay, and so what we're going to read, remember what we were actually being saving as a string right here, which we're going to convert over into an integer, was actually the index of the atoms that consist of this of the atoms that actually are bonded together, okay? So what I'm doing here is I'm, again, creating that integer, but I'm adding the current atom, the current number of atoms, which I had over here, okay? And that way, for instance, if I had originally my picture 10 atoms, and I'm reading in a new file with 10 atoms, well, the new atoms would get piled onto the previous list right here, okay? So that's why I have to add this number to each one of this. So I'm going to define my first atom, and then I'm going to read another token and define my second atom. Then I'm going to read the next token, and remember in our file format we had X. Next token, that's going to be Y. Next token, that will be Z. Okay. Now the rest of the code right here, if you think it looks familiar, it should be, because actually I copied most of this. I changed the variable names to match the variable names up here, but if I actually copied it over from my panel, okay. So look around and you'll see that that's actually copied from my panel, okay? Okay, so let's go ahead and see. Again, This is the IO, right? And the IO is going to read into the panel, right? It's going to add atoms and electrons to the list that we pass it, okay? Now, if you don't want this to happen, what you have to do is go back to my model, right? And before you read something or open something, you have to do file new, right? And clear and wipe everything out from there, okay? Okay, and then, of course, let's back up over here. And so this set file is going to actually get an input from the dialog, okay, just like we did before, and we're going to open up all of that to be able to read our files, okay? Okay, so let's go ahead and run the program and see if it works. Okay, so let's start this up, and we already had save, and we're gonna do save first, okay? So let's see, let's create maybe a little cube or something like that, okay? And okay, and let me go ahead and roll it on its side right here because it's pretty flat right now. Let me hit optimize, and I made a basket, okay? And for right now, we can't actually fix that, okay? Because we can't do delete or anything like this, but it's actually a cute little basket. So I'm gonna go ahead and save this basket just to have something to save, okay? I did want it to be a cube, but there's two of the vertices that actually got scrunched out, okay? So this is a flattened out cube, okay? So let me go ahead and go to the desktop, and let me go ahead and, okay? I'm gonna call this a bad cube. Now, I don't even have to use an extension here, so I'm just gonna go ahead and... Extensions are nice if you know, just to be able to know what kind of file types you're working with, okay? But not necessary for this program. Okay, so I'll hit save. Okay, now what I want to do is I want to go ahead and move this out of the way. Let me put it over here. And let me go ahead and hit open. Since I was the same time that I opened this, then it still had the name here. Otherwise, you'll have to select it. So we'll hit open. And then all of a sudden, now I have two things on here, right? If you didn't want two things on here, then you should have actually gone ahead and created a... let's make this big right here. Let me fit this on here. Okay, then what we should have done is we should have created just or hit file new, right? In fact, I can still go back here, open, and then open up bad cube. And let me just go ahead and fit that. And then I can go ahead and roll, and you can see it's an exact replica, right, from the file that we had before. In fact, let's go ahead and take a look at the file just to make sure. Okay, so here's bad cube. Let me go ahead and open it. Hopefully it'll open with, okay, if it doesn't open, okay, it'll open up with a text editor. Okay, the file's a little longer, but it's saying eight atoms. It's reading in the atoms. Should actually be reading eight C's or eight carbons right there. And after it finishes with all these carbons right here, let me see if it's around here. Okay, then here is where it starts off with a list. It's going to actually have 12 bonds. Right, it's going to be a bond between 0 and 1, and then it's all coordinates between 1 and 2, between 2 and 3, let's see, between 3 and 0, right, 0 and 4, and so forth, okay, and reading all the coordinates. So now we can read and write.